Okay, dear participants, now we are running short of time, so without wasting much time, we will proceed for the another session, right? So as per that, here I would like to give my introduction to you, because since many days we are interacting with us, but many of you don't know about me. So I would like to introduce myself. Myself, Dr. Damayanti Chivadka, Associate Professor in Civil Engineering Department from S.N. Patel Institute of Technology and Research at Kolkata. I have completed my PhD in Civil Engineering from SPNIT Surat in 2019. I have completed my M.Tech in Structural Engineering from SPNIT itself in 2013. I have completed B. Civil Engineering from Ali College Morbi, from our one speaker was there, in 2010. I have published more than 45 research papers in various national, international, UGC, Scopus, SCI journals and various conferences in India and abroad. I am a professional member in IEEE, American Society of Civil Engineering, American Concrete Institute, Indian chapter of American Concrete Institute, IST, IEI, ICI, IAM, ISSC, ISRO, IC, ISCA, SCFI, and so many professional bodies since 2020. I have delivered many expert talks at national and international level, collaborating with the different universities from India and abroad. I am an editor and reviewer of many Scopus Web of Science and UGC CAN journals. I have organized many technical events for students and faculty development throughout my career. I am here in S.N. Patel Institute, TNP officer, and Institute Innovation Council member, student startup innovation policy member, and research and development member of the institute. In the lockdown, I have recorded and uploaded 538 numbers of technical videos for GTU students in a different technical field. For that, if I will share about that achievements, then here I would like to share that I have received many awards during my career. So Academic Corona Warrior Award I received from Gujarat Technological University for uploading 538 video on a GTU video lecture website. And for that videos, for maximum view count, I received another Corona Warrior Award. I received Bright Researcher Award by International Institute of Organized Research in April 2019, Young Researcher Award in Civil Engineering by Global Outreach Research Award in January 2019, Best Young Researcher National Award in May 2018, Young Scientist Award from Sweden in year of 2016 and in year of 2017 from all over the globe. I have awarded Indian rupees 3 lakh for minor research project from Department of Science and Technology, which goes in 2016. Best Paper Award in February 2019 from International Youth Symposium. Best Paper Award from World Academic of Science and Engineering Technology, Turkey, in February 2018. I have awarded the government PM Modi scheme, Beti Bachao, Beti Padhao. As per that, I received a special appreciation and award from our central government in January 2018 on 26th of January. Received a financial grant of 75,000 from Fuel Elements, one of the leading industry. Received a grant of 20,000 from Department of Science and Technology, which goes to organize the 2-day national workshop. And received a sponsorship for 15,000 from Sai Infrastructure for Project Fair 2020. I have just recently published one patent and also published one book in 2020. So this is my brief profile. And by ending with my profile and my introduction, now I would like to start our third session. Maybe in these 2 days, you have learned so many things in a different field of civil engineering, right? So in our audience, if I am not wrong, so there are lots of industry person and most of PG students are there, right? So what they are seeking as a knowledge or as an advancement and what should be done, right? So as per that, we will start our session, and here I will share my PPT with you all. So just give me a minute. So I will share my PPT and we can start the session. Yes, I think my PPT is visible to you all.
Yes, it is.
Is it visible?
Yes, ma'am, it is.
Okay, okay. So with that, okay. So as we have already shared all the details in a group, so my topic for the today's presentation is like use of SCM, means supplementary cementitious material, as a smart material in concrete manufacturing. Okay. So first of all, that should be a question. Means we all are from civil engineering fraternity. So concrete is a very generalized word for all the civil engineer. Why? Because we know that we all are dealing with concrete. If you are in your office, in your work, in your workplace, at your home, or you are traveling from any mode, like from railway or from air or from at any place, so you are dealing with concrete. You are very deeply connected with concrete. So I can say, whatever your expertise field, like water resources, soil, transportation, construction engineering management, or you are dealing with any field of civil engineering, but concrete is in the heart of every person. Why? Because in the world after water, human being is using concrete in a very tremendous use. Means we can say that after water, we are using second most usable material, and that is concrete. Okay. So there is general term and phenomena in our mind. What is that? What is concrete? We have some rough idea and we have some general concept: cement, sand, aggregate, and water. But my dear friends, this is a very traditional way. Okay, fine. So if in a very past, in very ancient time, if we are looking back in past, and if we are feeling that there is a bicycle, right? So there was very odd type of bicycle, fine. So right now we can't use that type of odd or old fashioned, old designed and not having a good features bicycle in a right now present trend. Why? Because now we are developing countries and we need some development. Okay. So that traditional concrete was absolutely okay and fine in that ancient time. But right now the scenario is changed. If concrete is there, it is fulfilling its requirement in a strength, in a durability, or in a many factor, right? So this is simple concrete, right? But when we can say it's a smart, when any material we can say smart, whenever it is doing something advanced beyond its characteristic, right? So suppose we are talking about concrete. So this is a simple phenomena, which ingredient having a water cement aggregate, right? When we are talking about SCM, means supplementary cementitious material, why today we are discussing that? Because we are discussing challenges and opportunities. So what is the challenges in civil engineering field? We seen many fields, but if we are talking about the field of concrete, then I told that the concrete is the second most usable material, and during the cement production, concrete production, 1 ton of cement production is responsible for 1 ton of CO2 emission in an environment. So we can say that it is a really, really very big problem for our environment. We are facing many environmental issues because of that also. If we are dealing with any engineering field, we are doing any development, but because of our development, if our environment is in trouble, so this is not a real development, fine. And for that, we have to think what should be the opportunity to make this issue in any advantageous stage. Okay. And because of that, we are introducing many supplementary cementitious materials in the field of concrete to reduce the use of cement in concrete manufacturing. And we are introducing that material to use in a place of cement. And if that material will fulfill the requirement like cement and giving some beyond properties, some beyond characteristic in concrete, then we can say that yes, this is the smart material. So today we are going to discuss that why supplementary cementitious materials are smart material, and which supplementary cementitious material can be called as a smart supplementary cementitious material in concrete manufacturing. So first of all, water cement aggregate come in picture as a concrete afterward, as per our requirement, as per our application. If we need good tensile strength, good flexural strength, this concrete is not like that. We just build some structure and the concrete work is completed. This will not happen. that concrete structure should have some specific lifespan, whatever we decided, like 100 years, 200 years, 500 years, okay? So whatever span we decided, as per that, that structure should be in use, right? That should be error-free, okay? That will be not like that we constructed any breach or any building, and after few months or few years, you are reading in newspaper that this building or this bridge is collapsed. Okay, so this is the failure, right? So for our special application, for our special advantage, we are adding some admixtures, some super plasticizers, some other materials in concrete manufacturing to enhance the property of concrete. Now there should be a question. Till that, many concrete structures are there. That structure don't have any admixture or any super plasticizer or any SPM. So why we need today? That should be a question. So what is the answer of that question? In ancient time, the environment was like different. We can say use of that building, that structure was different. Right now, we are developing countries. Our use, our environment, our soil type, our soil characteristic, everything is different. Environment is different. So we should think that our structure should be sustained in all the conditions, like whether there is a heavy rain, heavy wind, any earthquake will be there, any cyclone will be there. If a heavy load vehicle will be passed on any road, if our high-rise buildings will be there, if we are constructing any aircraft, anything we are constructing. So that structure should be sustained all the load, and that can withstand again all the environmental conditions. Maybe there will be some alkaline or we can say that there is some acidic rain will be there on that concrete structure. So that structure should not decay. Okay. So right now, environment is changed, soil type is changed, and there are so many different changes are in environment, in our surroundings. So definitely concrete needs some advancement, and because of that advancement, we are using some smart admixtures, some super plasticizers in that. And apart from that, water, cement, aggregate and admixtures, whatever other materials which are having a similar type of properties like cement, which we are using in concrete manufacturing, this is our supplementary cementitious material. Okay, so not going through the all line by line, and if I will directly come to the point, then there are various supplementary cementitious materials like a fly ash, ground granulated blast furnace slag, rice husk gas, nano silica, silica fume, meta kaolin. Then municipal solid waste ash means whatever the waste will be there that we will burn, and whatever ash will be there that we will use in some percentage of replacement. What percentage should be there, that we will discuss step by step. Then various type of ashes. Then there are so many supplementary cementitious material. If we will talk about only that topic, supplementary cementitious material, then my dear friends, we need at least a day, because there are lots of material. So material don't have only its physical and chemical characteristic, but what will be its behavior actually in structure. Whenever you are doing prototype laboratory work, okay, so that characteristic will be different. And whenever that particular concrete you are using on field, on site, then your parameter, your characteristic, your strength, everything will be different. Okay. So to exactly understand and exactly get the idea of all the material, we need a week, right? Because this is a concrete is a very vast topic and having a lots of different type of parameter, but as the time is constrained, so we'll try to get a basic idea and recent advancement and what is the drawbacks, what are the benefits that we will discuss. So at first we will talk about the fly ash, very known to all the civil engineers, because this program is definitely for civil engineers. So all know the fly ash, right? We know that called fly ash. Generally, we are considering as a fly ash, like capital F means this is a fly ash. So depending on the quality, on its type, it's having a different oxides like silica, aluminium, calcium, okay? And it allowed to substitute cement and fine aggregate in concrete. Fly ash, which can be used as a cement and fine aggregate in concrete. If that will be in a granular type of part, and we will consider as a sand type, then it will be used as a aggregate in a concrete production. If we are like grinding that ash, okay, we are having that material in a grinding powder form, then it will be look like cement. In that PPT, that cursor is moving on the right side of the corner, so you can see the fly ash in a powder form like cement. Here from the picture you can see direct usage of fly ash people is using in a road construction also. This can be fly ash can be used in concrete production also. But if frankly speaking, there are many industry person also, so definitely this is the right platform to talk that matter. We are having lots of supplementary cementitious material, but because of the lack of awareness, lack of the drafting codes, lack of the exit codes, exit guidelines, we are not using that. So many persons over here, I am giving you many advantage, but I will tell, please use that fly ash in your home construction, okay? So no one will use that material in their. Why we are not confident? Because anyone want to gain degree, master degree, PhD degree, they are doing some sort of work. Some people need some grant, they are doing some sort of work. Some people need to fetch something, so they are just introducing some type of work. But that work should be continued in series. Means if any a person started work with its physical and chemical properties, then the remaining team of, means if any institute will be there, any organization will be there, any industry will be there. In our India, if I'm talking, many persons are planning for abroad for further study and research. Why we are not doing in India, right? We are having a many, I don't want to tell any institute or organization name, but we are having a many good reputed institutions, many government and private bodies, many good industries. So in that, what we can do? We have to take one project in our hand, and from starting to end, we have to do the number of test series in a laboratory as well in field, and then we have to give exact idea that please you use that material in construction. So cement use can be reduced, and that material we can use in a place of cement, and we can save the environment. But for that, good teamwork is required. Okay, so there is a fly ash use. In that graph you can see, that pie chart you can see, that it can be used in a aggregate, in concrete production, in a road construction, as a cement replacement, in a mining application. There are lots of use of a fly ash, but yes, it's a good use in a concrete manufacturing. But as I told, because of the lack of the awareness, knowledge or supporting document or standards, we are not using that much fly ash in concrete. Okay, if we are talking about its properties, right? So mainly we can say that fly ash is a byproduct material, and its physical, mineralogical and chemical properties strongly depend on the type and mineralogical composition of coal. If you are staying in Gujarat, okay, and if at different places you are collecting ash, so both the materials properties will be different, it will be not like similar. Okay, so depending on, suppose one plant will be there, so in one plant, if one batch is giving a fly ash material, then in second batch that material's property will be changed, right? So there are so many factors affect on that, and for which factors are affecting more, for that very deep research is required, and we are seeking for that. So what are the physical properties? Generally, fly ash, it's a rounded, irregular or angular, mostly in a spherical shape. Surface is generally smooth, but varies between different type of fly ash. Its shape, quality of fly ash particle, surface effect, amount of water needed for desirable workability in a concrete. Because whenever concrete having a new material, so we should check its a fresh properties, mainly workability, if it is workable or not. What its final time or final setting time, initial setting time. So these are the important factors whenever we are using, and this is the scanning electronic microscopy. Whenever we human being having any problem, or if we are don't have any problem and we have to check our body structure, whether every bone and everything are at appropriate place or not. So we are doing what X-ray we are doing. So in concrete, our X-ray is a scanning electronic microscopy. In that, we can see the bond of fly ash having a little good bond. This from the literature. So if we are talking about chemical and mineralogical properties, then we can say that chemical compositions in a major constituent are silica, which is SiO2, alumina, calcium, iron oxides. Besides them, it contains magnesium, sodium, titanium, sulfur, potassium, and many oxides are there. This is actually list and percentage, but as I told, it will the characteristic will vary from plant to plant, from batch to batch. That's why the proportion range is given in range, not exact number. Classification will be based on the plant, its shape, its size. So there is a class N type, class F type, class C type, and based on that the properties are varies in a fly ash. And we can say that whenever we are making concrete from fly ash, so that will be little bit advantageous. Why? Because cement use is reduced, workability will be good. European standard also gives us some guideline and classification about fly ash, and this is only for our knowledge. Like if loss of ignition will be less than 5%, 10,000, 7%, then classification B. If it is less than 9%, then this is a C. And based on, and if we are talking about its, if we are talking, if we are talking about its, fly ash type, then there is a type N and type S. So in that, INC will be there. If you people did your what I can say that cement practical, and in that we are using the sieve analysis, right? So if fly ash retrieved on sieve is 45 micrometer size, then that will be type N type of fly ash, and if that will less than 12% then retrieved on Indian standard sieve 45 micrometer, then that will be fly ash, right? So here I just wanted to tell you about the high volume fly ash concrete, where the content of fly ash will be more. Okay, so we will not read all the things, but please see over here, image is there, water, cement, fine aggregate, coarse aggregate, you can see the proportion. But whenever HVFAC means high volume fly ash concrete will be there, so in that you can say that we have water same quantity, cement quantity is less. What we did some replacement with the fly ash, water, cement, fly ash, fine aggregate little bit reduced. And here you can see coarse aggregate, fine. So in high volume fly ash concrete, what will be there? We have to do some partial replacement of cement with fly ash. Partial replacement means less than 50% replacement we have to meet. Okay. If we are talking about physical properties of high volume fly ash concrete, then it will the use of fly ash in concrete reduce water demand for a given workability. Okay, so we can say that we can save the water because right now water is also a problem for us. Many places we are facing scarcity of water, right? Base effect on workability have particles smaller than cement but larger than silica fume particles. So we can say there will be an adverse effect on workability also whenever we are using fly ash in concrete. But if number of series of practical done on that, then we can give the exact idea. Okay, so all that contained based on less experiment, more literature survey, right? If we will low the water cement ratio, then that will increase the paste to volume in concrete and better packing density of high volume fly ash concrete, which is generally more cohesive, and it, and that can decrease the bleeding and segregation in concrete. So we can say our concrete will be good, right? As I told, reason for laser use of high volume fly ash, inconsistency will be there, lower early edge strength will be there, okay? Contradiction in results found in the existing literature means whatever researchers results, whatever practically we are doing, so there is a contradiction in results, and because of that also mainly we are not using high volume fly ash concrete, right? There is a poor durability of high volume fly ash concrete exposed to carbonation, and that is decaying our structure, okay? So this is also one of the reasons we are not using high volume fly ash concrete. Now we are turning on GGBFS, ground granulated blast furnace slag. So during the iron ore process in many steel manufacturing industries, like there are, I will actually, this is the online program and recording is there, so I'm not the not authorized to take name of any industry, but I will tell and you can get the idea. There are many steel industries who are manufacturing steel, and during the iron ore process there is a granular type material will be there. That granular material here, you can see in a slide, here you are seeing one lady, she's myself only. During my PhD doctoral program I visited industry, collected that industry waste, or we can say byproduct, okay? So that will be in a granular part, and that granular part will be in a sun drying process, means we have to lay on any layer and we have to do sun drying, not the oven drying, right? So sun drying process will be there. That granular part we have to do in a grinding unit, and one powder form will be there. That powder form is a granulated blast furnace slag, and this is its a physical property. Due to time constraint, I will not read each and every property, because we will provide you the material. The main thing, whenever you are talking about material, so this is compulsion that we have to give idea about physical and chemical properties. Okay, so there is some any big science or big rocket science behind that physical chemical properties. But as this is a trend, so we are talking and we are observing and we are mentioning the physical chemical properties, but whenever civil engineering field is concerned, concrete is concerned, any material is concerned, then we have to definitely, what we can say, that this is the common formality that physical and chemical properties are required, right? So if we are talking about chemical properties, so silica, alumina, calcium, magnesium, such type of compositions are there, total principal constitution are 95.92%, and main chemical constitution of BFS and ordinary Portland cement are similar. So also whatever supplementary cementitious materials list we have, we can say that GGBFS is the best material. Why we can say like that? Because I just told you that that was my PhD project, right? So in that, from zero to and means we have taken a material replacement 0%, 10%, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, and 100% replacement with cement. We perform number of series for like compressive strength, tensile strength, flexural strength, shear strength, impact strength. We did a durability taste for NaCl curing, MgSO4 curing, H2SO4 curing. We have given high temperature to our specimen. We tested that series till 6 months only. That I have to accept because also I need my degree on time, right? Otherwise we can, if we're really on field, we need some very good extent because then we have to extend our study in 4-5 years or maybe 20 years, 100 years, right? But this is not possible for us when we are doing PhD. But we try to do maximum series of experiments in concrete to give exact idea about that material. And as for our experience in that material, we will not talk about the literature, but even we will talk about this, that literature, whatever we need and whatever results we achieve, these are similar. So I am not talking about literature and everything. Because if I am having my own experience, right, my own research, my own work, then why I should rely on anything? Because whatever I did with a very expert team, like many ultratech cement, then slow elements, then there are many industries, many good and many expert people involved in that work with me during my PhD work, and we performed very good things. So I cannot give you any literature detail, but I will give you the exact detail what we exactly did on field and in lab. Because whatever the doctoral research on that we did in laboratory, but is it good or like anything is missing or perfect or not? So for that we did on field also, right? And for the study, we found that 50% replacement was the good, having a good compressive strength, good tensile strength, good flexural strength, good shear strength, and we are reducing the cost of concrete also. Exactly, I didn't remember the figure, but yes, if 50% GGB we used in place of cement, in 50% cement, 50% GGB. So, if 1 cubic meter concrete will be from 3000 to 5000, so it is directly reducing from 2000 to 2000 to 4500, because depending on grade, cubic meter of concrete size are well. So if we are talking about the hardening properties of concrete, so yes, that is having a good, all the hardening properties are very excellent whenever we are using GGB reference in optimum quantity. Optimum means whatever required, whatever sufficient quantity, and that is found. Many literature are saying 20%, 30%, 40%, 50%, right? So I will go with the 50% because that was my experience during my 4 year of journey of my doctoral research. So I will go with the 50%. And based on that, we also published so many papers which are accepted by like Scopus, UGC, Lab of Science, Reputed Journal. And based on that, whatever you see in beginning my that award, so that I received from different countries for this contribution. So we use the scanning electronic microscopy of GGB concrete, where you can see the matrix of cement, which is having a good bond. Interfacial transition zone means whatever aggregate and whatever matrix means cement and best. Okay, so whatever face is there and whatever aggregate is there. So there is, you can see the thin line, it's not a crack. There you can see there is a connection joint between aggregate and matrix. This is a very good bond we see in a scanning electronic microscopy, and very micro crack. Eight microcrack we did after the after measuring the compressive strength means we broken that cube, and after testing that cube, whatever broken material there, from that broken material we did scanning electronic microscopy. So you can see that is a very less microcracks are there. So we came to the conclusion that its bonding is very good, its inner structure is very good. So microstructure is very good, then its shrinkage swelling effect is very less on concrete, and concrete is dense, having good strength, and based on that GGBFS replacement and porosity, you can compare the best result. You can see at some places you are seeing like a higher porosity at 65%, lower porosity at 35%, but this is I taken from my literature, but I will from my experience I will come to the conclusion that 50% replacement is good, but no doubt this is the lecture, so I have to also include other researchers' point of view too, because I can't I can't insist anyone please you consider my only. So I put other researchers' work also here for your reference. So as per our talk that in a FIFO effect, means if temperature is suddenly raised or temperature is suddenly down, so in that case also GGBFS is also we can use in various places for different type of structure. Hydrogen process is also good. Then whenever we are doing chloride ingress or carbonation, doing that also GTG found good in a place of cement with 50% replacement as per the my research. And then we come to the rice husk ash, means whenever rice will be there, its cover will be there. So it will burn its cover and then we will sieve that, and whatever powder form is there, that will be the rice husk ash, right? So in that we will not wait the thing, but we will come to directly the main point, that the hydrogen mechanism of cement paste containing rice husk ash, you can see that this is the hydrogen process of 0 to 3 hours, this is 3 to 8 hours, this is 8 to 40 hours, and after 40 hours you can exactly see the CSS gel, which is a very important parameter in concrete. So from that, what we can say, rice husk ash is blended cement and is known to contribute to concrete strength from as early as 1 to 3 days of maturation. In addition to its contribution to strength, even at relatively small replacement dosage of only 10% by weight of cement, RSA can produce a strong transition zone and very low permeability in hardened concrete, which is a very good sign. Since Portland cement is typically the most expensive constituent of concrete, the replacement of RSA will be good as an economic point of view for concrete manufacturing. What are the applications? For blended cement, to make green concrete, to make high performance concrete, for refractory purpose, for roofing shingles, for ceramic glaze, insulator, waterproofing chemical, oil spill absorbent, for such type of application we are using. And as I told, there will be a rice cover. We have to grind, then we have to burn, and whatever we will do the sieve analysis, sieving process, and we will find a great powder type of cement type of form that we can use in a place of cement at 10% replacement. And these are the chemical parameter. So for different type of we can say as per the different place will be there, different land will be there, so as per that this percentage will well. Okay, so here properties of fresh concrete containing RHA. So here you can get the exact idea. Just a minute, give me 1 second. Just give me 1 minute. Here you can see that 20 megapascal strength, 25 megapascal strength, right? And 30 megapascal strength, 40 megapascal strength, right? So based on that strength, what you can see, that these all are the RHA, rice husk ash replacement percentage, okay? Here you can see the different water cement ratio, different slump and different compaction factor. So based on that table, you can see that if replacement will increase, so as per that, slump is decreased at some level, compaction factor variation will be there. So RHAs are used in concrete will be reduced, the initial slump, right? And therefore the use of higher water cement ratio or a workability in enhancing admixture in concrete containing RHA may be required. Means whenever we are using a rice husk ash in a place of cement, so as per our application of structure, for which application we are making structure using 10% replacement RHA in a concrete manufacturing, so we have to use admixture or any super plasticizer as per the application. Here you can see the final initial setting time based on the RHA replacement. Okay. Here, whatever you see over there, this is reflected over here in a simple graphical point of view. So if we are talking about properties, so So due to microporous character, RHA absorb a large amount of water, which not only reduce the bleeding but also help in limiting the interfrim of bleed water on the underside of aggregate particles. As a result of the aggregate base bond is improved, and this is a good sign for concrete. RHA concrete achieved a higher strength layer with a control concrete, means 100% cement will be there. And if we are doing some partial replacement with RHA, then we will achieve good strength. In general, we can say RHA content increased to 15%. There was an improvement in all the mechanical properties, though beyond this concentration, a reduction in strength was noted by researchers, and this is the one of the major aspects. People are not using RHA in concrete. Okay. This is we are talking about opportunities and challenges, right? That's why I am talking about all the SPM materials. These are smart, but because of the lack of awareness, lack research, not perfect result, not serious research, we are not using in field, right? So another thing we are talking, so high replacement level of RHA coupled with high water cement ratio, depth of carbonation will increase when compared to fly ash. So RHA is a better for corrosion resistance. In a freeze thaw performance, RHA is like we can say there is a endure 300 cycle without reaching the failure limit. Concrete containing RHA was found to be much more resistant to 1% HCl solution than the concrete without RHA. These are the properties in Na2SO4 solution and MgSO4 solution. So we can see that what will be the effect of Na2SO4, MgSO4 type of chemicals on concrete containing RHA. So here you can see after 28 days curing, these are the strength in a megapascal, right? So this is the control, means 100% cement is there. There is a 7% replacement, there is a 10% replacement, there is a 15% replacement. So whenever control concrete will be there and 28 days normal curing will be there, so this is the strength. Okay, but after 2 months we are doing here from that result, from that table, from that graph, I just wanted to tell that RHA is a good smart supplement with cementitious material in concrete manufacturing. But my dear friends, my dear industry person, my dear students, my colleagues, I just wanted to convey that because of lack of research, lack number of trades, they are not using that material in concrete manufacturing in a wide way. Now we are talking about nanosilica and silica fume. So silica fume is a byproduct of smelting process in silicon industry. Okay, this is very good advantageous material having a good properties whenever we are using in concrete. So you can see the property I will share. You can go in detail and you can personally contact me if you want to gain or discuss more things in depth on that. But what I want to tell and I want to convey, this is the strength and durability issue because this is the concrete. Okay, many researchers worked on the application of silica fume in concrete to understand its fundamental effect. Silica fume can be used efficiently in concrete where good quality coarse aggregate is not readily available. Addition of silica fume enhances the compressive and tensile strength of blended concrete, which is a very good sign. Optimum replacement percentage of silica fume in concrete is not constant, rather it is different for every water binder ratio of concrete mix as shown in figure. So you can see that. Wait a minute. Hello sir, am I audible? Hello? Hello?
Yes, here.
Okay. Thank you. So here you can see the compressive strength for different type of concrete grade, M20 to M50 grade of concrete. We are observing over here. You can see the replacement. You can see the strength at 7 days and 28 days. Okay. So you can see that at 28 days, at the 7.5 replacement, M50 grade of concrete with the 7.5 earlier, or we can say that at a 7.5% replacement, it is having a very good and higher strength, right? So we can say silica film is very good in a strength point of view, because whenever if we are asking any fit person, so if your strength is good, then they are passing your concrete, okay? So as per that, it is good, but why it is not good, that we have to discuss. It is for health and safety issue. Because silica film, nano silica film usage on commercial level is increasing exponentially, resulting in this increased human exposure. And due to very fine particle, health and safety aspect of SF and NS, silica film and nano silica are very serious concern, especially application of nano silica in construction sector have many hurdles due to environmental hazard also, and there is an adverse effect and on human body also, right? So because of health and safety issues, mean we are not using silica film nano silica. But if we are having advanced technology, whenever we are using it in concrete manufacturing, then definitely we can use, if we can concern safety first, okay? And if we are having such type of good environment to use that material in concrete, then that will be very good, right? Silica film enhances the corrosion resistance, which is a good sign for concrete, alkali silica expansion. However, it tends to increase the carbonation depth. There is still need to develop standard specification, which we are lacking in all the supplementary cementitious material. And for that, we academic and industry person have to do lot of research on that. This is the metakaolin, this is the one type of calcined clay, and it comes from calcination of kaolin clay. And then have been some interest in the use of metakaolin in recent year on also. Among the different sorts of kaolin, the Chinese tea is considered to be very pure, and it is composed chiefly of the mineral kaolinite, which occurs in the deposit of China clay rock, a mixture of 15% China clay and 10% mica, and the remainder of quartz. My dear friends, due to COVID corona environment, please forgive me to use that China, but what I can do, this is coming under the metakaolin, so definitely I have to share with you, okay? So please don't hesitate with the China word, because I know this is the COVID and pandemic, and we face very hard problems, right? So many people don't want to even listen that word. So extremely sorry for that, but this is coming under that topic, so I have to use, right? Metakaolin differs from the other supplementary cementitious materials in that it is not a waste byproduct resulting from industrial activities, nor it is completely natural. Okay, so we can't say it is like any waste. Okay, what are the characteristics? Definition of kaolin clay mainly depend on purity and nature of the mineral of kaolin type in the original raw material, on treatment condition, and on the finest degree of the end product. More than 80%. The main characteristic of metakaolin is the pozzolanic activity, which is the ability of metakaolin to react in the presence of water with calcium hydroxide to form hydrogen silicate gel, hydrogen product. Fresh properties, then setting time can be reduced. Okay, it will increase the heat of hydration, it will accelerate the effect of cement hydration. Then, wherever free flow effect will be there, so at that place we can use that metakaolin. So, few supplementary cementitious material good in hot weathering conditions, some are good in cold weathering conditions. So, we can say that metakaolin is good in cold weather concrete. What are the mechanical properties? It contributes in the strength development, which is the major concern for any civil engineering. Its performance is very good, very effective in increasing strength beyond 40 days also, right? So these are its good properties. Depending upon purity, metakaolin can be effective pozzolana if used in cement-based system. In that, it leads to strength enhancement, lower drying shrinkage, and high reliability. Metakaolin with high quality is much more expensive than cement, and this will affect the unit cost of concrete. Therefore, other type of metakaolin needs to be explored. Means we industry academic people have to do combine more research on that. If the metakaolin is not pure, the strength of concrete may not be enhanced. In recent years, metakaolin started to gain interest, and it is expected that it uses in concrete applications will increase in the future. However, it is important to find suitable preparation and calculating method that is efficient and economical viable, right? So if I will directly, as we have to complete our session in 4, and as per that the general discussion, if I will come to the conclusion, then global tendencies for sustainable development had their influence on the construction industry as well. Regardless of sustainability, fly ash has been used in concrete for decades because of its positive effect on some durability aspects and lower price. On its way from power plant landfills to concrete, fly ash overcome many obstacles, but there is still a long way until the safe daily use in construction industry is possible. GTBFS mostly improved durability properties of kind of concrete and mortar. Many properties of concrete or mortar, such as permeability, creep, shrinkage, resistance to free flow, sulfate resistance, alkali silica reactivity, abrasion resistance, high temperature resistance, resistance to chloride penetration, and chloride binding capacity were examined. GTBFS decreased permeability of concrete and improved resistance to sulfate and seawater attack. There seemed to be lack of information about the reaction mechanism of nano silica. A detailed study is required to investigate the nanochemistry to assess, interpret, and visualize the reaction mechanism. Development of new family of nano superplasticizer may be very useful for proper dispersion of nanoparticles, which will result in extracting maximum benefit from using nanosilica. Using pozzolanic material in cement retreat system can enhance the durability of material produced. Okay, so before saying thanks to you all, I just wanted to convey as per my topic that you know that topic is the use of smart supplementary material in concrete production, right? So here, my dear friends, my dear colleagues, my students, all the respected industry persons, as the workshop name is challenges and opportunities. So we have to understand all the challenges. We have to understand all the challenges which we are facing in construction field, mainly dealing with the concrete production. We all have to work together that how we can overcome this problem with a proper number of experimental work and series work. It will be not like that I did some experimental part and I am coming to the conclusion. So that is the very wrong practice for researchers, for faculty, for industry person, and that's why to bridge the gap between industry and academia, we selected the topic that this is the challenges, and we are having the opportunity to work on this issue very, very deeply by the collective effort from so many experiments, by giving some draft, by giving some guidelines, and we can use such type of supplementary cemented material in concrete production to reduce the use of cement and to save environment. Then and only we can say that yes, we are developing in the field of civil engineering, and these all the materials are really smart materials. So here I am concluding. Thanks to all. Now you all have 5 minutes because our chief guest is with us. So any person want to ask any question, they can directly write in chat box. They can ask the question. And if any person want to interact with me directly, so we can say that you can directly email me, you can directly WhatsApp me, because in WhatsApp my number is there. So thanks to one and all. Thank you so much. Yes, sir.
On behalf of each and every participant and us for organizing group, we would like to thank you for conducting this nice and informative lecture, ma'am. And I would also like to thank the principal of SNPITRC, head civil engineering department, and you, ma'am, the organizer, for organizing this training program. Thank you very much, ma'am.
Thank you, sir.